So in this lecture of serving, we are going to see the introductory part, which is definition of serving, then object of serving, and various uses of serving. So moving on to the first thing, which is definition. See, serving is defined as the art of determining relative positions of different objects on the surface of the earth, above the surface of the earth, and below the surface of the earth, by measuring distances between them. Okay, let's say, for example, this is a reference point, let's say A. Now we can determine where this point lying on the surface of the earth from A is, how much distant it is from point A. Then this point above the surface of the earth, we can determine by leveling, by horizontal and by angular measurement, how far and where exactly the point located is from reference point A. And this point below the surface of the earth, where exactly this point by level or by horizontal measurement or by angular measurement, exact location can be traced with respect to the reference point A. Okay, this is the definition. Art of determining relative position of different objects on, above, or below the surface of the earth by measuring distances between them. Okay, the distances can be horizontal and vertical. Now specifically, when we say the distances are vertical, we are talking about leveling, which is measurement of elevation. Okay, which is measurement of vertical distances. Leveling is measurement of vertical distances. Okay, so now we are at the third part, that is, what is the exact motto or what is the object of survey. See, the object of survey is to prepare a map. See, this is a map we are talking about, and the key characteristic or the special characteristic or the characteristic of a map is its scale. Because when we are saying that we are picking some characteristic features, some observations on a paper, whether it is a digital or analog map, we are picking up some characteristic and features of that specific region we are going surveying for. Then the features, the characteristics, for example, in this map we can see a canal, then roadway, some property lines have been given. Then we need to have some scale for that. Okay, the key parameter of a map is its scale. Okay, because whatever details that are on the area are scaled and then picturized on this map. Okay, the object of surveying is to prepare a map. Now let's see what are the types of map, what are the several types of map we create by conducting survey. See, uses of surveying. Use of surveying and object of surveying is to prepare a map. And now we are at the topic, we are at the point where we are going to create either a topographical map or a cadastral map or engineering map or military map, contour, geological and archaeological map. Now from the names itself, from the title itself, we can conclude what kind of detail we are going to see in a specific map after we carry out surveying for that. Okay, means when we are talking about topographical map, topography will be displayed. When we are talking about cadastral map, we are going to see boundary lines. When we say engineering map, we are going to see engineering projects. When we say military map, then strategically important point from point of view of defense of that country can be seen. When we say contour map, then we are going to see elevations and depressions in form of contour lines. When we say geological map, we are going to see geologically important features or characteristic of that area in that map. When we say archaeological map, then we are going to see the relics of antiquity. Okay, now let's see one by one how this topographical map, cadastral map show the specific characteristics of that area. So we are at topographical map. See, when we say topographical map, we are looking at natural and artificial features of that area. Now what are the natural features? Say a river, okay, or let's say lake. Here you can see a lake, or let's say mountains. Then hills. Okay, then artificial features means whatever man-made features are in there in that area can be seen in a topographical map. Okay, in short, the map shows topography. And as always, when we say map, the key ingredient will be a scale over there. Okay, now let's take a look at what cadastral map is. See, when we say a cadastral map, we are talking about boundary lines. Okay, remember this word. Whenever you say cadastral, you have to remember this word, boundary. Okay, means when a cadastral map is prepared, its main motto is to indicate the property or boundary lines, let's say, of a state, of a city, of a town, or let's say a country also. Okay, and whenever a property is exchanged between two owners. Okay, let's say this is owner A and owner B. Then, if this person A is a buyer and this person B is a seller, then the exact location of the property, for example, this is the property we are talking about. Then, the lines, the boundary lines of that property or the property lines we are talking about are shown on a cadastral map. Okay, that exchange will take place by conducting a cadastral survey, and cadastral map will be prepared, and by conducting that cadastral survey, the exchange, the selling or buying of the property is going to take place. Okay, then we are at engineering map. See, when we say the word engineering, we are looking at engineering projects such as road network, then railway network, then we can say irrigation network, okay, or we can say sewage network or water carriage network. Okay, all these details are shown in an engineering map. Means whatever the ongoing project or design of the project or planning of the project or future prospect of the project can be shown in a engineering map, in an engineering map. Okay, means whatever the details that are necessary for, let's say, planning, then design, execution and future projection can be seen in an engineering map, and that engineering map is prepared after carrying out an engineering survey of that field or of that vicinity. Okay, now let's see what a military map is. See, when we say military map, we are talking about strategically important point for the defense of that country. Okay, whatever the road network, whatever the connectivity of an area for having protection of that area or for defending that area are shown in a military map. Okay, then the contour map. See, in a contour map you are going to see some contour lines. See, for example, in this contour map we can see some lines, and these lines are nothing but points of equal elevation joined together. A contour line shows points of equal elevation. Now, one line shows a specific elevation, therefore number of lines will be showing their specific elevation or let's say depression. Okay, means from that numbers, from that line, we can determine which exact area is depressed and which exact area is elevated. For example, if you want to determine catchment area for a dam, then from the depressions, from the contour map, we can calculate how much volume of water can be stored in that specific reservoir. Okay, therefore, a contour map is useful in order to calculate, let's say, catchment area, or let's say how much volume of the water is going to store during after completion of the dam, or let's say how much rainwater is going to get stored or accumulated, or ponding of rainwater will take place in an area during rainfall or after the rainfall, or let's say after the rainy season. Okay, then we are at geological map. As the name is suggesting, when we say geology, we are talking about type of soil and type of rocks. Okay, these two things make up the geological characteristics of an area. Now, in this map, what we are seeing, a color code to type of soil and type of rock which is on the surface, or let's say below the surface of the area is given. Okay, for example, each color will be showing a specific type of either rock or let's say either soil. Okay, whatever the underground and the surface resources are can be seen in a geological map. And to prepare a geological map, what we need? Geological survey. Okay, after conducting geological survey, we will be able to create a geological map. Now we are at the last type of map that we can prepare by carrying out a survey. Archaeological map shows the locations of ancient relics of antiquity, some hidden treasures in the ground. Let's say in this example, the Harappa civilization can be seen on the map. Okay, therefore whatever the archaeologically important points are there in an area are shown on archaeological map. Means whatever the types of map we saw are showing the specific characteristic or feature of that area. When we said the map is a cadastral map, we were talking about property lines. When we said military map, we were talking about all the points important from point of view of defense. And thereby, when we are saying archaeological map, we are seeing only the points which are important from archaeological properties of that area. Okay, so that was all regarding definition of survey, object of survey, and various uses of survey. If you like the video, please hit the like button. Do subscribe to Simplified Learning for more such videos. And I will see you in the next lecture. Till then, take care. Bye bye.